MiniMax M2 is free until November 7th. I'll show you why it belongs inside of your CloudCode workflow. Hello, I'm Jeremy Groh, founder of Metadata Fusion. In this video, I will be installing M2 MiniMax inside of CloudCode, covering its speed, stability, and current free-tier pricing, plus showing you how to switch between providers such as Anthropic, GLM, Kimi K2, DeepSeek, and Qwen. With the one command setup from my CloudCode multi-provider setup and switcher guide, available free at my website, MetadataFusion.com, under Resources, Guides. MiniMax M2. As you can see on the screen, it's free until November 7th. We're 2025, in case somebody's watching this old. So definitely worth having a look at, especially if you like to work with CloudCode, because I have my CloudCode multi-provider setup and switcher guide that you can obtain from my website, MetadataFusion.com, under Resources Guides, which will show you how to install this and switch between them. And you can also install Kimi K2, DeepSeek, GLM 4.6, which is one of my favorites at the time. And I'm actually, upon initial testing, MiniMax M2 is somewhat comparing to GLM, which I really like this model. They're claiming that they built this model for agentic coding, and they're claiming that they built this thing to be efficient. Obviously, they're claiming it's 8% the price of Claude Sonnet, which is quite interesting. We will have to do some head-to-head testing. Please reply in the comments if you would like to see me do some head-to-head tests between this Sonnet, GLM, maybe Kimi K2, because we can actually run all of those inside of CloudCode. And you can get this on my CloudCode multi-provider setup and switcher guide. It will show you how to install all these models inside of CloudCode, and you can switch back and forth. And I think it's very good to have multi-providers inside of your toolkit. Myself, I work with a lot of providers, and I'm definitely willing to use new tools when they come out, if they're better than my current tool stack. My current favorite tools is Factory AI Droid, I really like, and CloudCode is probably my top two. But of course, I still use the IDE of Cursor and KiloCode, etc. I use some of those tools, but I'm always trying out all the new tools. They're claiming that their team has tuned this model to handle a variety of tasks, which is quite interesting. And one thing with benchmarks, I'm not sure if everyone is aware, a lot of the AI providers, they tune their models specifically for those benchmarks. So depending on what type of code base you're working on, some of these benchmarks don't really stack up against real world uses. As you'll see down here in the guide, where MiniMax is stacking up, and it's stacking up pretty well. If you'll see it, they're compared to Anthropic and Codex. You'll see ZAI, but you'll see it's doing really strong on Terminal Bench. But I think it's very important to perform a lot of our own testing, especially with depending on the workflow that you are running, because these benchmarks may not apply to your dev workflow, depending on if you're doing full stack development, you're working on the front end, the back end. It's really going to depend on that. But I think it's really good to have a lot of these models in your toolkit. So let's see how MiniMax M2's pricing stacks up against Anthropic, GLM, DeepSeek, and Qwen. So right now you can see that it's free, obviously. But input tokens, looking at 30 cents, output tokens, $1.20. As compared to Sonnet 4.5, that's a significant difference, as we already assumed. So it looks like it's even coming in cheaper than GLM. But the difference from GLM is their coding plans. Their coding plans are extremely affordable. I know I've taken advantage of their coding plan myself, because they're basically giving half off on your first month, quarter, or year. I actually did the quarter, because the value was just too good to ignore. So if you're looking at API costs, it looks like it's coming in cheaper than GLM. But if you're going with GLM's coding plans, I think GLM is going to come in way cheaper. So it will be interesting to see if MiniMax M2 is going to come up with a plan. And you can see how it also compares to DeepSeek. Pretty similar pricing to DeepSeek and then the Qwen models as well. So let's get this installed. So the Claude Code Multi-Provider Setup and Switcher Guide, which is available at my website, mediadatafusion.com, under Resources Guides. This will show you how you can install MiniMax M2, but you can also install other providers. So you can also switch between the native Anthropic. You can install GLM, MiniMax, that's what I said, Kimi K2, Qwen, and DeepSeek. And then we have an alternative way that you can switch between models. All this is provided in the guide. So on this machine, I only have ZAI installed in my Claude Code. But I'm going to add in the Anthropic, and we're going to add in MiniMax. We'll see if I'm going to add, I might go ahead and add Kimi K2, and I might add DeepSeek. I work between multiple machines, so we can do a fresh install for this video. Okay, so we're going to go down to what's going to be relevant for me. If you don't have Claude Code installed, there's the basic instructions for that, of course. But I'm going to need to install the Anthropic native because I already have GLM. Then we're going to install MiniMax. Okay, so we're going to install these two initially. And then we'll set up the switcher and then we'll go from there. So since I in my Claude Code on this machine, I have it set up currently to run only GLM 4.6. So in order to add the switcher, I also want to add the native Anthropic. So let's first add that here now. I would just paste that in and we will run that command. Okay, so now I've got that in there. Okay, so now I would also like to add MiniMax. I'm going to go ahead and add Kimi K2 and DeepSeek. So let's me run all three of those in a row and then we will set up the switcher. Okay, now we're going to install MiniMax. You can see my key is there. And don't worry, it will be deleted. All these keys will be deleted after this video is posted. So no worries there. I don't have any fun using it. Okay, now we have installed MiniMax. So let's go ahead and get the Kimi K2. Okay, now we're going to install Kimi K2. Okay, perfect. Now we have Kimi K2 inside of there. Now let's add DeepSeek. So this will be our last one. Now let's add DeepSeek. So we've got all those installed, but now we need to install our switcher and then we need to make it active live. So now we're back over here on my guide, which I will show you how to set up the switcher. For those of you that want to pick up this guide, it's available at mediadatafusion.com. Under Resources, the guide section, you can pick this up absolutely free. So you'll see there the various commands that I use to install that. It's pretty straightforward. But now we need to set up the switcher. So here's this switcher guide. So basically, once we install this, we'll be able to type CCA to switch between models. So it should say active. So if we type in CCA, it's going to be Anthropic active. CCG, it's going to be GLM active. CCM, it'll be MiniMax. CCK, it'll be Kimi K2. CCQ, Qwen. CCD, DeepSeek, etc. Pretty straightforward. This is an optional if you want to use generic. So you can type CCUs and then the name and switch between. That will be optional. Set up for those who like to customize different things. So I provided that as an extra. So we are going to need the CCA. We're going to need the CCG because that's what I currently have for GLM. We're going to need the CCM for MiniMax. We're going to need the CCK for K2. And we're going to need the CCD. We won't need the Qwen because we're going to skip on the Qwen for now. Okay, so let's get that installed. So let's get the switcher set up. So we got that in there. Let's hit enter. Perfect. So now we need to make this active. So I'll take you back to the guide. So you'll see here on the guide, We want to load this now for the current shell. So let's just copy and paste that in terminal. All right, let's make it active. Perfect. So let's see if we are working. So let's type CCA for Anthropic. Perfect, Anthropic. So let's do Minimax, CCM. That simple. And we could just literally type Claude. It's just that easy. I could just hop out of this. And let's say we want to go back to Anthropic, CCA. And then we could type in Claude. Simple. And now we're on Anthropic. And let's get out of here. We'll hit Control C twice. We're out. Let's go to Kimi K2. Fine. And we hit Claude. Boom, we're in. And now we're on Kimi K2. We go to model, select the model, and we've got our different models inside of there. And Kimi K2 has a very nice model. The 0905 preview is really actually a powerful model. It's quite interesting for various tasks. So let's get out of here and actually go to a repo and let's give Minimax M2 a spin. So let's confirm that we're on Minimax. We're gonna type in CCM. Perfect. So let's just type Claude. All right, let's make sure that we're on the model that we want. Let's check out the models. So let's give this thing a run. We're going to make sure we're in plan mode. Okay, let's see if we can turn thinking on. Okay, well, all of our commands are working. So thinking on, we're in plan mode. Let's go ahead and give it a test prompt to see how Minimax is working. Okay. Let's give it a whirl. And that's one of the things that I think all of you that are watching, we really enjoy the Claude Code workflow and they're continually updating it. But also another one of my favorites that's similar to Claude Code, but they have their own tools, which is Factory AI Droid is another one of my favorites. So let's give this thing a whirl and see how it's running. Let's check out the speed and how this is working. And if you would like me on some future videos to do some comparisons between Minimax M2, GLM 4.6, Sonnet 4.5, Codex, etc., let me know in the comments and I can possibly put together some of those videos. But let's see what Minimax M2 is doing. It has been comparable close to GLM 4.6, but to be determined. But it's absolutely free currently right now. So I would definitely recommend adding it to your toolkit. Specifically, you can go to my website, metadatafusion.com, under the resources section guides. You can get my Claude Code multi-provider setup and switcher guide. And you can have all these models inside of your Claude Code. And you can switch back and forth, whether you want to use the native Anthropic, whether you want to use GLM, whether you want to use Kimi K2, whether you want to use DeepSeek, Qwen, etc. You can use all that inside of Claude Code. So here's the plan for Minimax. I'm not wanting to act on this plan, so I'm going to hit no. I actually just wanted to see the output. Let's make sure that all of our Claude functions are here. Everything is there. So let's actually run that same command with another model, just for a comparison to see what type of output we'll get. And also demonstrate the switcher again. So we're going to hit Control-C twice to get out. So let's give DeepSeek a run with the exact same command, just for comparison. Let's check our model. Now DeepSeek chat, perfect. Make sure we have thinking on. And let's give it a roll. Same command that we gave to Minimax, M2. So it's doing the same analysis that we did with Minimax. And that's just how easy it is. You can switch back and forth between the providers. You can go from MiniMax to DeepSeek to Kimi K2. You can go to Anthropic. You can go to Qwen. Unfortunately, you won't be able to run GPT models and some other models inside of here. This is where I like Factory AI Troid as well, because I can run pretty much anything in my Factory AI Droid. If I get some people in the comments wanting me to update my Factory AI Droid guide, I have also a switcher. Well, I have a way that I can add many, many custom models inside of Factory AI Droid. If I get some users that would like that updated, please put that in the comments and I could update that guide on how to install and GPT-5 inside of Anthropic, all the Codex models, all the Anthropic models, Kimi K2, Minimax, etc. So here we go. This is what DeepSeek, this is the plan that DeepSeek has given us. Actually quite a bit of detail, not bad. Definitely different than the Minimax output. I'm going to have to say I'm going to prefer this DeepSeek's plan with this specific task. But keep in mind, this was just one prompt head-to-head from Minimax to DeepSeek. So I think Minimax was quicker, but I do like the output just a little bit better from DeepSeek. But still a lot of testing to be done with these new models. Keep in mind, Minimax M2 is absolutely free until November 7th. So that's one thing to keep in mind. But yeah, DeepSeek definitely, I think, did a more thorough audit of this code base and gave me more detail. I am very, very big on plan mode. It's definitely something that I really use in my day-to-day dev work. And this is a much better analysis. But still more testing to be done. M2 Minimax was not bad. And we all have to keep in mind that you're going to use different tools for different tasks. Conclusion, keep Claude code and change the backend. Minimax M2 and others on demand. Get the full Claude code, multi-provider setup and switcher guide on my website, MetaDataFusion.com, under Resources, Guides. That's it for me. Subscribe, like, and I'll see you in the next one.